Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.
So I invite you to relax even deeper into the vibration of the music. For the vibration of the music harmonizes the movement of our bodies, the beating of our hearts, relaxes us. So as you breathe, allow yourself to feel the life force that's moving through you, to feel the strength of who you are. Phil Moore says that God is the strength of my life, and I am power in every part. You are power. You are strength. You are love. So as we come into this time and place and space, it is a reminder of who we truly are. Beings of light, of love, strengthened by our knowledge, our awareness, our willingness to know God. And as we experience this strength, we recognize that our faith increases. Faith in knowing that we are about God's work. So we relax into faith and life. We have been given life, abundant life. See it, we feel it, and we rejoice in it. And this knowing of light, and this knowing of strength, and this knowing that we're experiencing in this moment gives us an opportunity to go within, to that sacred place. Shut the door and to listen for guidance, to listen for a feeling of strength, faith. We listen. And in our listening, we begin to see with new eyes. We begin to hear with new ears. We begin to feel a most sacred place. We recognize that we are fully alive. And in this aliveness, we let gratitude pour forth. In gratitude, saying, thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. We allow ourselves the opportunity to bring our awareness back to this time and space. Softly and quietly affirming, thank you, God. Thank you, God. And it is so, and so it is. Amen. To thank everybody who participates in creating this service on Sunday, and for our musicians that bring such love and harmony into the energy and the flow of the service. There are times that I find myself going into the meditation and kind of forgetting that I'm supposed to be at some place standing up, going, oh, okay. I have a part here. I'm off. So we've been talking about the 12 powers, and we are talking about aspects of who we are and what we are as expressions of God. 12 powers. Each of us has that within us, and so we have the opportunity to strengthen it when it needs to be strengthened, to dampen it down if maybe we're overzealous, or I don't know, we can't overlove, and I guess we could overorganize. So, but basically, we're here to remember that these are aspects of ourselves, and with these aspects, we can call them forth as needed. So we're talking about spiritual power today, and most of us know about physical power. We've been to the gym, we've worked out, we've tried to build the muscles and make ourselves look some special way, right? So we know what that's like. But what about the spiritual strength that we call on, use, and have the opportunity to know about in our lives? I decided last week that what I would do is share a service with you from Charles Fillmore, dated September 28, 1913. It is on the power of strength, and it's just a few pages. And after a while, I decided maybe that really wasn't what you would want to hear. So it is taken from that, but I am not reading it to you. Thank you. Yes, really. And I'm telling you, some of his English, we just don't know how to deal with it today, because he's got some antiquated phrases that makes me smile anyway. So spiritual strength, what is it? How do we develop it? Where are we going to use it? How are we going to use it? And is it one of those aspects that we use all by itself? So strength is the ability to endure, stay the course, persevere. The disciple is Andrew. It represents stability that lies in the foundation of every true character. The corresponding color is light green. I forgot to wear that today. And the location is the small of the back. So that's what we're talking about. How do we get there? It's like building physical strength. We have to work at it. We have to work out. We have to build it. We have to build that spiritual strength through working out. How do you do that? You know, we talk about different things in here, and we use different affirmations, and we affirm, and we make commitments that we're going to go out and we're going to be different, and we're going to come from a place of love. And then something happens, and everything starts to kind of crumble, and you go, oh no, oh no, oh no, here I go again. Ah, strength. Ah, strength. I'm affirming divine strength in this moment to remember who I am, to let go of those thoughts that are pushing me back, but to remember. I love this very first sentence that Charles started with. We are met for the purpose of getting a fuller understanding of the powers of latent within us. Our prayers, our meditation, all of our words should tend to the one point in the lesson, and that is strength. So when we talk about strength in the small of the back, we're also given the opportunity to remember that that is close to the life energy. And it is close to faith, because when we practice strength, we are required to move into a place of faith. So a couple of weeks ago, no, last week, I handed out the mnemonics of the 12 powers. And it's not so important to remember them just because. It's an opportunity to remember them and use them as they connect together. And so Charles says, all the powers of command are related. No man liveth unto himself alone. That's from Romans, actually. So no facility of the mind is independent of other faculties. No faculties of the mind are independent of the other. We have often had our attention called to the illustration of the chain being as strong as its weakest link, and no stronger. Exactly the same is true of man. If you have a weak link in the chain of your thought, your whole character lacks, has a weakness, is able to come apart there. So it is ours to lift up our consciousness into that divine standard, to that place where there is an absolute strength and there is a oneness of mind. It's an opportunity to remember the truth of who we are. And that's important that we do that again and again. And if we exercise our minds in the great strength field, it will translate into your character muscles. I love that. So if we exercise our strength in our hearts and our minds, then we will experience it in the muscles of our being, of our goodness, of our character muscles. I love it, character muscles. So central in this is that we recognize that God is the strength of our life and that we are powerful in every part. We are powerful in every part of who and what we are. Sometimes we forget. We have an opportunity to remember. So in the scriptures, we have Samson. And we know that Samson was a very powerful man. And yet, he began to focus on something outside of himself. This woman who drew him out and convinced him to tell how he got his power. And as he did that, she made sure that he was asleep and she began to cut his hair. He lost his strength because he began to focus outside. How often do we lose our strength when we forget and we focus on something outside of ourselves? Be it a relationship, be it money, be it whatever, a drug, all those different things. When we focus outside ourselves, we forget what's in here. And that's what happened to Samson. And so he lost his spiritual consciousness that gave him the physical strength. However, we have another opportunity in the Bible to look at one of the characters that represents who and what we are and who and what we can do. You know that every bit of the Bible is about us. It may not be about us going out to slay people in the physical world, but let me ask you about some of your mind thoughts. Is that slaying people? So I had a real tough time with that. I'll just be honest and say, I had a tough time with every story in the Bible is about me. Oh, wow. Wait, I would never do that. I would never go out and hurt somebody. Well, yes, I would in my mind, and I do, or I have. Maybe that's all past. So it's important that we remember David and Goliath. Because David is a representation of love, and he stood firm in his truth, in that truth of who he was. So here's this little boy, a little boy, named David, representing love. And here's this big character that somebody wants dead. Now, I think about our own lives, of how often there's this big giant out there. Or at least we think it's a giant. It feels big. Again, money, relationship, all those different things, addiction. It feels so big, that giant. And then we come, as David came, with love, with strength, with conviction of who and what he was and is in us today. He showed us a way to overcome the giant, very easily, very peacefully. Well, it wasn't peacefully, I guess, with one stone, but it lacked all of that drama. He did it without drama. I like that too. So it's important that we remember that we have been called to express, to be, to love, to overcome our giants. Some of you may feel like we have a giant coming up. You know, we have to find a new minister oh gosh, she's just going to be here until, and then we're going to find a new minister. It's not a giant, folks. We come with love. We come with strength. We come with divine purpose and order. That's what we're about. And we're going to do this in such a wonderful way that you're just going to go, oh, okay. This is great. This is love. This is what it's all about. This is community. And this is home. And we're going to express that with joy and peace. We can do that. We're going to follow the guidelines that have been set forth, and we're going to do that. So where did David get his power? He got it from God. Where do we get our power? We get it from God. Where do we get our strength? We get it from God. Where do we get our faith? We get it from God. So I showed some mnemonics on this, and I'm just going to kind of go through that. So David was about love, and he used his imagination to create a way in which to handle the situation. And that was that he stepped up in power and strength to do what was his to do, L-I-P-S. And then he went on in faith, expressing life and order and wisdom. You see how we can use those 12 powers and see them in our lives, but more importantly, call on them as we need them. We can continue with that part of wisdom and understanding and zeal and release or forgiveness. These are powerful tools that we have. Powerful tools. And this is the time that we have to call on each one of them to be fully present to this time and place as who you are, wonderful and beautiful, divine beings expressing the Christ. And I just invite you, if there's anybody that's kind of annoying you in your life, to walk up to them and in your mind say, the divine in me greets the divine in you. The divine in me, let's affirm that together. The divine in me greets the divine in you. Namaste.